afternoon. Good midday. Welcome in. This is Cup of Joe Midday Madness on Tide 100.9. It's a little slower, a little slower. Welcome in, Cup of Toad, Tide 100.9. There we go. We got, want to say big thanks. Yep. Okay. All right. Get my head all back on straight. Big thanks to Martin and Xavier Houston getting our day started with the Martin Houston Show. You heard him weekday 6 until 7. Our man, Whippenberry Sanderson from 7 to 9. I just filled in for the Gary Harris Show. I'll be with you till noon. We'll pass it off to Big Noon Sports, Matt Coulter, Lars Anderson, and Christian Miller. And then I'll be back with you till 2. We'll pass to Stingray. Stingray is going to have his episode tonight, and we'll do a little Trent Richardson and Chuck Oliver tonight. We'll keep it locked into Tide 100.9. We'll be live and local all day long. And download the Tide 100.9 app. It's the best way to keep up with all your Alabama Crimson Tide news. You can jump in and join the show on the Twitter machine today at Aiden_Dollins, at JoeGate36, at Septimus_44, SEPPITUMS.
Yes? PP.
_44. You can send us your comments, questions, queries, and complaints right there. And then you can jump in and join us on the Dairy Daniel State Farm hotline this morning at 205-342-9904. Really appreciate our friend Dairy Daniel sponsoring the show. You can go see him for all your home, life, and auto insurance needs. Dairy Daniel, like a good neighbor, Dairy Daniel and State Farm is there. Okay, we've had a lot of fun already. 2 hours on the Gary Harris Show. We've kind of worked into some conversations already today. We may repeat a little bit, but that's all right. We already talked on the Gary Harris Show about softball. We talked about the NBA playoffs. We talked to Rodney Orr, and we talked to Karen Johns. I'm not talking to any guests right here. I'm talking to Aiden. I'm talking to Sepp, and I'm talking to you right here in this hour. Okay, so let's open up a conversation that developed over the weekend. A conversation we have started to have at some points on Cup of Joe. We've talked about guns a lot on Cup of Joe. We've talked about guns and sports a lot on Cup of Joe. And you may be tired of it. That's fine. If you are, we'll be back on at 12 o'clock with Big Noon Sports, and they'll give you your X's and O's and Jimmy's and Joe's. But look, John Morant gets in trouble again over the weekend, and there's just so many layers to this to get into. John Morant gets in trouble over the weekend because he's on Instagram Live. For everybody who doesn't know Instagram, it's just a social media account or social media app where you're just sharing pictures and videos. It's basically a very visually stimulating app. So John Morant is on Instagram Live. The camera is on him, and he is dancing to music, as lots of people do on Instagram Live, because that's just a way to kind of feel yourself. It's very popular, just dancing around. I'm feeling myself. I'm putting it on social media. Problem. Ja Morant, in the middle of the video, pulls out a little firearm, pulls out a gun. And, all right, this is a layered conversation because this is the second time he's going to be caught on an Instagram Live video flashing guns, and really his third or fourth gun incident that he's had in his two or three years in the league. So he's just kind of gotten into a lot of gun issues in his very young NBA career. And John Morant is a hell of a player. He's incredible. He's amazing. Now, this is going to be, what do the Memphis Grizzlies do? What are they going to do? They announced a indefinite suspension, but who cares? Because, look, no basketball games on the horizon, no practice on the horizon, no team activities on the horizon. He's suspended. For we don't know what the NBA spokesperson: we are aware of a social media post involving John Morant, are in the process of gathering more information. Circle back 6, 8, 10 weeks ago, John Morant has the first incident and he serves an 8-game suspension, 10-game suspension, and some of that was already grandfathered in because he sat out for mental health or this, that, or the other. So he suspended 8 games after meeting with Commissioner Adam Silver in March. So it was about a month ago. And after the suspension, Morant tells ESPN he now realizes what he's got to lose. He needs to be, quote, more responsible, more smarter, and staying away from all the bad decisions. Well, first off, it's more responsible and smarter. You can't be more smarter, can you?
Not grammatically, but.
Okay, alright. I have to be smarter. So John Morant, we gotta work on that, not Wright State. What was their, the tiny school we came from.
Murray State.
Thank you very much. Gotta work on that Murray State education there. But John Morant, he does it again. He's on Instagram Live. He does it again. Now, look, there's three of us in here. And four, if you count you the listener, I out of the four of us, there's probably a handful of guns, a handful of firearms in our possession. The four of us. Now, not here in the studio. I can only speak for myself. I have not concealed carried into the studio, but I am not inherently against guns. And I've tried to say that on the outset anytime we have these conversations. Guns are not a toy, though. They should be treated with respect and be treated as the dangerous weapon that they are. Now, Ja Morant is 23. Well, how old is he?
Yes, he's 23.
Yeah, 23 years old. So of legal age, he can cast a vote. He's of legal firearm carrying age. So you got layers of this discussion here. Is Ja Morant allowed to carry a gun? Well, I am allowed to carry a gun. Sepp and Aiden, unless there's felonies in your history I don't know about, I believe that you are allowed to carry a gun. And so it's not my business. Like, yes, Sepp, you're technically my employee, even though I don't really like that distinction because we kind of work together. But like, I don't really, if you got firearms in your house, if you want to put them on your social media and say, hey, look, don't come into my house because I'm protected, or hey, look, I'm about to go hunting next weekend with this firearm, or hey, look, I just like handguns and I collect them and this is what I have. Like, that's your business. I, as your employer, am not really, I don't know. I don't feel right about saying, Aiden, I don't like you putting that gun on your social media. You're suspended from work for a week. I think that's a little, I don't know. I don't know if that's good, but you gotta throw in when you're talking about Ja Morant, you gotta throw in.
He's a public figure.
Yes. Thank you. Stop talking about that. I'm thinking about the incident with the daggum Minnesota Timberwolves. It's cool if you're gonna own a gun and own a gun responsibly. I am in favor of that. Green light to that. Green light to you. Responsibly own your gun because welcome to the Second Amendment. I love the First Amendment. If you love the First Amendment, you cannot love the First Amendment without loving and respecting the Second Amendment. I think they go hand in hand. Oh my gosh, Ja Morant, I think you haven't obviously violated the First or the Second Amendment, but I think you've obviously shown a tendency to be a little reckless with your firearms already. And so, Ja Morant, look, I think if this was the only incident last weekend, I'm going to show my gun in my video, while I'm dancing and rapping and singing. Like, I think that's, you know, here's my prop. That's part of it. Whatever. But if you cannot do that, you cannot do that if earlier in the season, you and your boys, or at least your boys, your friends,
you were in the car with them,
right, are pointing firearms at an opposing team. So if my man Aiden gets in an argument with another employee and just across the parking lot points his firearm, which I know you would not do, but if he did, that would be something I would have to be like, whoa. Now my employer relationship, the gun is all kind of coincided.
Now we gotta have a conversation.
Right. You cannot have an altercation at work followed up with firearms. I mean, come on. Look, I've had altercations at work. I've been angry at this job and other jobs plenty of times. And, you know, verbal.
We've worked in restaurants.
Of course.
We know what happens back of house.
Yes, exactly. Oh, my gosh. To result to, hey, we had an argument, and now I'm going to point a gun at you in a parking lot. Oh, Ja, you got to be smarter than this. I know you're in Memphis, and I know at the end of the games, everybody's chanting, whoop that trick. And I know 3-6 Mafia is big in Memphis. And like, it's kind of culture in Memphis. It's kind of culture to be, it's kind of in to be tough. It's kind of in to be hard. Don't try me. Don't test me. We're in Memphis. We're going to take, you know, Zach Randolph on the basketball court set that table in Memphis, but it's been the culture in Memphis off the floor forever and ever and ever, ever since I can remember.
We just got a fresh reminder of that with the young Dolph.
Exactly. It's a Ja. So, look, there's a lot of layers to this. Should Ja Morant be in trouble? I don't know. I don't know because as a red blooded American, what has John Morant really done wrong? What has he done wrong to warrant these problems? He's got several off the court incidents. He's being sued by a teenager for punching him in the backyard over a one on one fight
and flashing guns at him.
Right.
Pointing the gun at him.
And so, Ja, like, you're dancing in the area of, okay, I'm legally owning my gun or I'm not legally. I'm brandishing my gun as a threat, which, you know, sometimes that might have to happen in certain situations, but you can't just.
You can't flash guns at a 17-year-old to beat you in basketball.
Right. So, Ja, and like, you get a lot of people upset about him being reprimanded by the NBA because, hey, you know, he's not doing anything. Look, inherently, any of us can show our firearm on Instagram Live. Any of us can. But I think if I have been known to use my firearm irresponsibly, or to use my firearm threatening a child, or to use my firearm to threaten... I mean, I know the Timberwolves aren't technically their co-workers, but they are co-workers.
What about
I was going to bring up that whole incident with them, like, flashing lasers at that. Like, yeah, like, that's a... That, people have forgotten, I think, largely about that whole scenario.
Right. What about when the grocery store, like department store worker, got into a tiffle with his mother, and he sent his boys, like 9 of them, to roll up and like threaten the security guard?
Ja, man, I don't know.
What do you think? You're Gilbert Arenas?
Well, I mean, Gilbert even still is a little. Gilbert, I kind of grasp more because, hey, you and I are having a gambling dispute. You haven't paid me. I've let this go for a while. You haven't paid me. Now I'm angry. I'm mad. Give me my dadgum money. Okay, I'm now threatening you. I'm putting 4 guns in the locker room and saying, pick one. I'm going to shoot at you with it unless you pay me my money. Like, it was all tactical to get paid. And yes, 50 game suspension for Gilbert Arenas. 50 games for bringing a gun into the locker room. Unloaded gun into the locker room. I don't understand what Ja's going for, though. At 23 years old, the world at your feet. I mean, you can live in Memphis and not find... I'm sorry, I'm not trying to disparage Memphis, but you can live in Memphis and not get involved in some of the riffraff that goes along in Memphis. And you can still have the attitude of, don't mess with me. I'm tough. We're Memphis strong. We're tough. We're going to be edgy. We're not here to be bleeped around with. You're not going to push me around. And you can have that attitude on the court all you want. And you can enjoy whoop that trick. What is this? Hustle and flow. You can enjoy hustle and flow all you want and everything that goes on with it. You have everything at your. I don't understand. This is where I'm coming up short. I don't understand where an athlete at 23 years old who has the world on his feet, who is millionaire, who is at the peak of his sport, also has to prove, yes, I am a gangster. Yes, I am not one to be trifled with off the court. Because you think about players not to be trifled with on the court, many names come to mind, but they never had to prove anything off the floor. They were just tough guys on the court. They played their tails off. Sometimes things got physical, but like, I don't need to know about, I don't know.
What Shaquille O'Neal never stepped a toe out of line with regards
to
anything.
Yeah, not really. Barely,
like,
yeah.
Epitome of class.
Yeah. And so I don't understand. What are you trying to prove at 23 years old? What are you trying to show America? What are you trying to show yourself? What are you trying to show your team, your city? I don't know what you're trying to achieve at this point, because I understand we're 23 years old. I'm aiming to achieve basketball stardom. Okay, you're on the path. You are achieving that. And look, if you feel like you need to own firearms to protect yourself, or just because you like them, Second Amendment says it's your right.
You do not need a reason.
Right, of course. But I don't understand the need to put myself into the need to put to prove to the world that, hey, I'm not one to be messed with. You know, he's throwing up, honestly, he's throwing up gang signs in the games, and word and stories have come out that some of these Memphis gangs aren't very happy with them using some of these gang signs because you haven't, quote, paid your dues. So, and look, if you don't know what that means, you haven't done crimes.
On their behalf.
Right. And so, like, I don't understand what you're trying to prove, Ja. You're already one of the most electric players in the NBA. look, you are a superstar. You're a TikTok hero because mans can fly and dunk over anybody. And that is a 15-second clip waiting to happen for TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, everywhere to go. And you're exploding. I don't know what you're trying to prove, getting into these incidents.
Why do you feel so insecure about having gone to a private college preparatory high school? What about that makes you feel lesser than?
I don't know, but we've spent about our whole first segment on it, and we got a couple of callers, so we're going to hit our break, Aiden. We're going to hit our break on Cup of Joe. Oh, yeah, lines available right now. If you want to talk about John Morant, you want to talk about firearms, you want to talk about legally owning firearms or illegally owning firearms, that's cool. You want to talk about Alabama football, I've got Alabama football topics on deck all day. We talked about softball in the last show and NBA as well. So, look, the phone lines are open for whatever you want. We're going to talk to Bama Nick, and we're going to talk to Jeff in Tennessee. We'll talk to you guys on the Derek Daniels State Farm Hotline at 205-342-9904, and then we'll just keep it rolling right here on Cup of Joe. This is Tide 100.9.
Home base right here in Birmingham, Alabama.
We are here treating patients from every generation
across the United States
and from around the world.
As respected industry leaders,
we are here
working hard for you
in an effort to provide you with
excellence in sports medicine,
excellence in research and education,
and excellence in sports injury prevention.
We are here for you,
aggressively pursuing
victory over injury.
Learn more at andrewsportsmedicine.com.
Work is a part of all of us. Working drives us to push beyond what we thought was imaginable and allows us to come together again for the things that really matter. That's why the Alabama Department of Labor and the Alabama Career Center System is here to help you discover bigger opportunities than ever before. Visit your local career center or alabamaworks.alabama.gov. Funding provided by the USDOL, PTA, and Federal WIOM, and Equal Opportunity Employer Program. Auxiliary aids and services available upon request. Brought to you by this station and the Alabama Broadcasters Association.
Tide 100.9, Tuscaloosa weather.
A hot, humid afternoon. The chance of scattered showers and thunderstorms through tonight. The high today, 90. Tonight's low, 67. For tomorrow, a mixture of clouds and sunshine with scattered showers and thunderstorms around. The high at 87. I'm James Spann on the ABC 3340 Weather Center on Tide 100.9. It's 89. Degrees in Tuscaloosa.
Cup of Joe, little midday madness on Tide 100.9. Sepp Shirey, Aiden Dollins, Joe Gaither, and 3-6 Mafia bringing us back in on a Monday. Let's head out to our Derek Daniels State Farm hotline. We'll find our friends Bama Nick, then Jeff in Tennessee, and then you can call in on the Derek Daniels State Farm hotline. Two lines available right now at 205-342-9904. Bama Nick, what's good on a Monday?
Hey, Cup of Joe, what's up?
What's going on, my man? How we feeling over there in Georgia?
Oh, it's nice over here today, Cup of Joe. Real nice.
Yeah, it's beautiful over here. You having a good day so far? What's on your mind this morning?
Well, I talked to my agent, talked to Fowler's agent Friday. I'm supposed to fill in for you today over at Ryan's show.
Okay. You calling back in about 2 o'clock?
Yeah, I'm going to call in, but I ain't going to be able to get there because, you know, I planned on coming over there, but I had a tooth. I had an emergency tooth. I had to take a tooth out. So my agent called your agent. Well, I'm calling to let you know. I won't be able to fill in the day for you over there.
Okay. All right.
Well, maybe tomorrow. I might try to get there tomorrow. Oh, Fowler said, let him know.
Yeah, Bama, if you come, you can hang out with me as long as you want. How about that?
That sounds great, Cup of Joe.
That sounds great,
my man.
All right.
I was just relaying a message. Fowler told me to call and let you know. So.
Well, I appreciate you doing that. Ryan's got me set up for a good week. I'm looking forward to filling in for him, but I'm hoping to hear from you and all the callers as well throughout the week.
Oh, you will. You will. I told Ryan I'd be calling the show while you're there.
There you go. Bama Nick, I love you, man. I hope you have a great day. I hope that tooth gets better.
I'll talk to you later on today.
Yes, sir. I hope that tooth gets better. That's Bama Nick hanging out with us. Let's head out. Jeff. Jeff's getting ready for spring fling. What's going on, my man?
Well, it won't be too much longer, so.
another busy week, but I see where Bama paid off the committee. I'm going to
How much do you think that cost us?
I might be with Jeff on this one.
Probably cost about $100,000. Probably knowing y'all, probably paid about $100,000. So I don't know why y'all owe something.
$100,000 bill.
I guess we got Montana fast over my arms hurting today. I can't quite move it.
Well, it's not her arm, Jeff.
What's in her leg?
I think she's hurt her foot. I think she's hurt her
foot. I think she hyperextended that knee.
Oh, God.
Well, I just know she's hurt, and I know that if she's not pitching, they're vulnerable, and they're not as good as they've been in the past. When you lose to Lehigh and Georgia Southern, it's time to get up.
Did Kentucky get in the tournament?
Yes, they did. They're going to Northwestern. They're not hosting every year like Bama. They don't pay the committee. We don't host every year.
Well, did y'all beat nine?
They're not very good.
Did you get nine wins over top 10 teams this year?
No, we're 30-20-1. We tied Texas though. We did tie Texas.
You tied Texas.
Perennial world.
There you go. Nine wins over top 10 teams this year, and we didn't tie Texas.
Well, I mean that's fine. I mean, that's fine. But we have to go to Northwestern and. We'll see what we can do. Like I told y'all, they're not very good. They're not very consistent. So I'll be surprised if they get out of Edmondson with the regional title and go to the super regionals. It's Rachel Lawson's the best job he's ever done. But we did eliminate them in the men's tennis tournament. So that's a good thing. And we are still alive, unlike Bama tennis that is practicing at Tuscaloosa High School today. We're going to Orlando, Florida.
Oh, I'm brokenhearted over our tennis team.
I know they're practicing.
He does know there's no Tuscaloosa High School, right?
They're practicing Tuscaloosa High School.
No, he doesn't.
Today. They're practicing Tuscaloosa High School with a JV today.
Hey, Jeff, where's Tuscaloosa High School?
Tuscaloosa. Alaska, I don't know.
I've never heard of Tuscaloosa.
Well, I've never heard of Nick Saban High School. That's probably one of the ones we built pretty soon. I've never heard of one.
They usually wait until it's posthumous. We do have a Paul W. Bryant High School.
Nick Saban and Miss Terry High School. Miss Terry.
She might get her own, too.
If Miss Terry's in charge of the school, that school is going straight to the top.
Oh, yeah. Miss Terry High School. But I saw where they're hosting, and yes, my alma mater is coming down there. They were down there. Several years ago.
Oh, yeah.
And, they are coming.
Come on down, Jeff.
You're gonna join us, so Jeff. We'll buy you a hot dog.
They are coming down there, and they did come down a few years ago. None of these players were on that team, but they won't be scared not of anybody. The team they're playing, they were supposed to play during the season. The game got rained out in Central Arkansas. So, like I said, they're not scared of anybody. We'll line up against anybody.
Did you ask them?
No. Jeff Reed, their coach, was pretty good at the high school.
Did you call him and ask him if he was afraid?
No. We're not scared of anybody.
How do you know that?
Because I know I'm a Raider alum. I know.
Did you call and ask him?
They already know him. I know four of them. Two of them I know played in high school.
Did you text them and say, "Hey, Sal, are you afraid?"
No, believe me, they know they're not scared of anybody. They're not scared of the Rose House, and they're not scared of. They're not scared of the Suds bucket in Bill Durham. They're not scared of either one of them.
Okay.
What is that? The road tab? Is that like Suds bucket in Bill Durham? Is that what it is?
What are you talking about?
Somebody that donated a lot of money, Jeff. You know how these things work.
That's how it works. They donated 10 trillion. So y'all
John and Ann Rhodes.
The Rhodes House. Well, that's a real creative name.
It is right next to the road.
Right next to the road. Well, you'll be all right.
It's R-H-O-A-D. John and Ann Rhodes.
I know how it's spelled. Well, let's see if you can get Montana out there, because if she don't pitch, Alabama's rolling for a day right now.
Well, breaking news.
And you guys know it. And Patrick Murphy, he needs to get up and quit making 20 World Series appearances, only winning one. Because like I told you, that guy called Feinbaum last year bitching.
No one cares about what nobody's calling that bald man and saying.
Well, I know they did. They called a job man called last year screaming and moaning about it.
Well, next time Paul Feinbaum's show makes any decisions...
No, I'm a fan, y'all.
I know, but who cares what a fan said?
Well, you don't care about the football fans, don't you?
Not really.
Nah.
Okay, you don't. We do this for our own fun. Well, you just do it for your fun. You ain't worried about Bama wins anything, y'all. Y'all just do it for fun, y'all. Y'all like the Andrew Griffith show. Y'all are funning.
As long as I get to sit in front of a television for 3 hours and drink 10 beers and watch some football, I'm having a great Saturday.
Yes, roll tide to that.
Well, if we beat you in softball now, we have to beat you in football in the fall. We're coming up here opening game in September.
Jeff, please come.
Please
come. No, I'll be busy with high school football on Friday, because if I miss one of those, I'm fired.
Oh, I don't want you to get fired.
Football is king in everywhere, especially the South.
So you're right on that. I don't want Jeff to get fired.
If I miss one of those, I'm automatically fired.
Well, we'll put your hot dog in the mail.
So y'all hang in there and send your Arkansas and Bill Tennant. Who y'all playing the first game? Who y'all playing?
Long Island.
Now we beat them in the tournament. We know about them.
All right.
We beat them right in the tournament. So all them threes coming up first. So see if y'all can get out of the Rose House again at the 25th time in a row. Y'all be hosting. I think y'all hosting since Methuselah, and you since 1570.
Yes.
95 BC. Y'all hosting since Martin Luther. So see if y'all can keep hosting now. Y'all hang in there and have a good week now.
You too, Jeff. That's a great time. Jeff in Tennessee. We are highly encouraging every one of our listeners not to get fired. So if Jeff is going to lose his job for coming down here for Alabama MTSU, then we encourage him not to do that. But, no, okay, look. What's wrong with – he's a – oh, we all have fun hosting for the 25th year in a row. What's – better than not hosting for – better than going to Northwestern. That's Evanston, Illinois, just north of Evansville. Evanston, just north of Chicago.
I don't know.
No, I mean – would you rather be hosting or going up to Chicago or not playing in the being out? I don't get.
I'd rather be hosting. Now, Joe, I can't remember. We might have touched on this in the Gary Harris show, but regardless of how the knee looks when Montana meets with the guy that did to his tightrope. That's
Lyle Kane, James Andrews, their whole crew.
She's meeting with Lyle Kane today and about eight other people. Now, regardless of how that knee looks, you've seen who we're playing. I'm sorry, Jeff, I don't mean any offense, but Middle Tennessee isn't a world beater in softball. Long Island doesn't scare me. And Central Arkansas, I really don't think is going to put up much of a fight. Would you roll out your three others as your pitchers, regardless of what the health of Montana Fouts' knee is, and save it for the Super Regional?
Yes. I mean, on the outset, yes.
You got to have her ready to go in the back pocket, I think.
Right. I agree, because it's a double elimination weekend. You have to lose twice to be out. And so literally, you keep that. I don't mean to be, burn the hand. Yeah, you keep that second loss in your back pocket. You let Alex Salter start the first game against LIU, and then ideally it's a win. And then you beat LIU. You play the winner of MTSU in Central Arkansas, and ideally it's a win against Salter or Torrance or Essman in that second game. And then your third game against the winner. It's probably going to be LIU. Your third game, you really just need to win three games. Three games to eliminate everybody, I think. Three or four. But with that second loss in your back pocket, yes, I would say, Montana, if you're 60%, you're not going. If you're 80%, you're not going. If you're at 100%, you're not going until we absolutely need you. Because next weekend, in a super regional scenario, Sepp, do me a quick look up of the NCAA tournament bracket for the ladies. You'll see who they're matched up with. You need Montana much more in that next weekend in the super regional event. So to answer your question, Salter, Alex Salter, Jalen Torrance, and Lauren Essman, you ladies have to get it done this weekend. And granted, if Montana can go and you're on that last loss or that second loss,
Montana's out there.
You're all out there. Let's head out to Derek Daniel before we hit our break. Derek Daniel, State Farm Hotline. We'll find our friend Julene. Julene, how's your Monday going?
Monday, fun day.
This is not Garfield.
Doing good. How are you?
Hey, you're doing a great job, first and foremost. You are absolutely rocking it, and your team, the whole team at Tide 100.9. Of course, I listen FM, but y'all are doing a great job. First and foremost, I want to say prayers go out to our ace pitcher, Montana Fouts.
Amen.
And hopefully we'll get a great report today. Second, I want to say, is Jeff PMSing today?
No more than usual.
Oh, Lord. I mean, half the time I can't even understand him.
There's a certain dialect of English you have to learn, and it makes it very entertaining, actually. It's worth putting in the effort.
I, you know, him being from Tennessee, and Joe, I don't want to disgrace you or anything, but is that your father?
No. I wish you, no. But ironically, my father's name is Jeff.
Okay. This is so funny, because the other night I was laying in bed, and I always, you know, before you go to sleep, you think that. I said, I got to ask Joe, is that his dad calling in and doing all this crazy stuff?
If it is, and I haven't known about that for forever, I'll be floored. But no,
I have a sneaking suspicion it's a long lost uncle.
Well, yeah, Jeff in Tennessee, you remember, used to call. I mean, he's been calling in the 11 o'clock slot forever since I can remember. He used to call Travis. He used to call Travis a lot when it was Southern Fried Sports, and then he would mess with Jacob when it was Off the Edge as well.
He did not like Jacob.
No, he didn't, because Jacob really was football only.
Yeah.
But anyway, okay, so, and I don't mean if it is.
No, go ahead.
I mean, I have a feeling, no, I'm not stupid, okay? But because I've heard him call your show and be serious, and I haven't heard much from your father since then, and I thought, that's him calling in and cracking up. But anyway, the next thing, what part of stupid don't you understand with Morant, okay? John,
amen. Morant,
what part of stupid don't you understand? Okay, that's all I want to say about that, okay?
I think John Morant knows a lot about stupid. He's doing it rather spectacularly.
Oh, gosh.
And just, Lord Jesus, help us. That man needs prayer big time. But to have a career like he's been blessed with and just, keep flashing, and keep being stupid. What part of stupid don't you understand? You can only flirt with the devil so many times. Okay, mm-hmm. That's all I'm going to say about that before I get upset and run my mouth too much on that. Joe, I want to piggyback to the episode you did with Rodney Orr.
Perfect. Yes.
On Gary's show, filling in for Gary. My thing with Dylan Lonergan, I still don't understand. Okay, he's on the football team. He's on the football roster. He's on the baseball roster. He's on the baseball roster. They say, who was it? Aiden said he couldn't go to the draft for 3 years.
Yes, but
that's how the new CBA works.
Okay, that's fine. I heard that. My question is, has he suited up and played on the baseball any of the games at all?
Nope. No, he has not.
Okay, so I'm confused about that because, I just thought I would bring that up. That was interesting, and I appreciate y'all asking Rodney that question and Aiden giving us the information, but
Julian, do you remember Keith Holcomb, who played at Hillcrest a couple of years ago, and Glenn Harbin, who was probably 3 or 4 years prior to that? Both those guys, Glenn Harbin and Keith Holcomb, played on the football and baseball team.
And baseball.
I would imagine that Dylan Lonergan, since he's an early enrollee, I would imagine everything he did this spring was for football, because that was really what he was early enrolling for, was to participate in football activities. But I would imagine he's on the baseball roster and has had conversations and probably done a couple, some team activities with them, but is not fully with the baseball team this spring. I would imagine that he will be more involved with the baseball team going forward as his traditional freshman year will get started in August. Does that make a little more sense?
Yes, it does. And when does the next baseball roster start after football?
They'll put out a new 2023 roster in August or in the fall at that point when they graduate the seniors off of this current roster. So he'll still be on. I'll guess, but I have a good feeling that my guess is accurate, that he will be on the baseball roster listed as a freshman this fall as well.
Okay, well, I just...
Basically, he's stealing a little extra time in college. He's still, we forget, he still should be in high school still. So I think that he's stealing just a little bit of extra, college time and choosing to put that towards football.
Can I delve into conspiracy?
Yeah, go for it.
I think Nick Saban put him on the baseball roster to ensure that he couldn't be drafted by the MLB before his freshman or sophomore year.
But is that a matter of being on the roster or just enrolled in college?
Well, that I don't know. I don't know about the hair parsing there.
I bet you it's just once you enroll in college, you're 3 years before you can get in.
Seb, can we get some fine details on that? Is that possible?
Yeah, and another thing, you guys, I follow Dylan and I follow his dad, Dylan's dad, Dan Lonergan, on Twitter. And if y'all could reach out to Dan Lonergan and see if he would talk to y'all on one of your shows, that would be interesting.
That would be a good idea. Yeah, Julian, we'll put in some legwork for
Dan
that.
Dan Lonergan.
Dan, where's Dan? Danny knows.
Dan the man.
Where's Dan?
Does he have legs?
Yeah, okay, I'm just confused about that. You know, I was hoping to see him play baseball, but obviously we need him in football too, don't we?
Yeah, I think he's going to be I bet you all his eggs are going to be in the football basket until Nick Saban says who the starting quarterback's going to be.
Okay, good stuff, Joe. I appreciate y'all. I love y'all. God bless y'all. And roll tide.
Roll tide, Julian. We love you, too. Thank you so much for calling in. That's Miss Julian on the hotline. Roll tide on the Derry Daniels State Farm hotline. You can jump in and join us. We've got about 20 more minutes left in the show. Oh, all right, pivot point, guys. Let's take a break and come back and close the show or keep going on. Miranda, what are we feeling here, Aiden? Break. Nothing. All right. Except we're going to hit a break. Well, the Derry Daniels State Farm Hotline will be open on the other side. We'll close it down on Cup of Joe right here on Tide 100.9.
From 0 to 60, way too fast.
Who knew electric vehicle owners were having so much fun?
20 or 30 years ago, I owned a gas sports car, and this car is much quicker.
It's a great, fun car to drive. When you put your foot on the accelerator, it just goes.
They're fun, they're fast, they're efficient.
Visit driveelectricalabama.com to learn how you can start having fun driving an electric vehicle.
Sponsored by the Alabama Clean Fuels Coalition, the ABA, and this station.
Back in. This is Cup of Joe, Midday Madness, my man, Seb Shirey and Aiden Dollins hanging out with me for 20 more minutes. Derry Daniels State Farm Hotline is open as well at 205-342-9904. I want to thank Bama Nick. I want to thank Julian. And I want to thank Joe and Doton and during the Gary Harris Show. And, of course, Jeff in Tennessee for hanging out with us on the hotlines this morning. All right, about 15 more minutes, and I feel like we've only scratched the surface here on the John Morant stuff, Aiden. And here's the extra layers. Okay, you have Pete on the outset, the very surface level of the story. You have, okay, athlete brandishes gun. Athlete has black eye on his program, on his franchise, the Grizzlies, and, you know, athletes suspended by NBA and by Memphis. But then, like, is he really doing anything wrong in these videos? Is he really doing anything wrong, illegal, or dangerous in these videos. I know that it's all about perception with the NBA. It's all about, we got to keep a clean image, and we got to keep, you know, we've been, honestly, the NBA has been fighting a perception problem for 20 years. I can remember my grandfather saying, "I don't watch those guys. I don't watch those tattooed guys, X, Y, Z." And okay, granddad, no problem. So they've been fighting a perception issue for as long as I can remember. But
was that any truer than in Washington, D.C.? But think of the lengths the NBA has gone to get away from this perception.
Right. You're now the Washington Wizards and not the Washington Bullets. And so, as a human, as an American, as an adult, is what he did, brandishing a gun in an Instagram Live video, really wrong or illegal or dangerous?
Well, it's a bit of a Schrodinger's cat situation on the dangerous. On principle, it's not wrong and it's definitely not illegal, but we have no idea if that gun's loaded or not.
Sure.
And if you're just kind of playing, essentially, with a loaded firearm, yes, that's dangerous.
Yes.
And there's going to be some people out there that are, you know, very big gun enthusiasts. They're like, well, you just don't do anything dumb with it. But to the average person, just brandishing a firearm while you're rolling around in the car with your buddies is a dangerous thing to do, especially if the gun is loaded. If it's not loaded, then there's absolutely nothing wrong with this, but we don't know if it was or not.
Yeah, and it's really just a general attitude towards the firearm that Ja Morant is showing. It's very casual. It's very cavalier. It's very
blasé.
Right. It's and okay, I understand that ultimately it can be just casual, but shoot, golly, how many, you can look up infant death, you can look at youth firearm deaths, I don't have the numbers right in front of me, but just from, oops!
Just how many stories can you remember seeing in the last couple of years of, like, toddler gets a hold of gun that was left out,
right,
and
right,
shoots
right.
dad in the leg or kills self or right. little sibling oh. or something?
And it just makes me so cringy. It makes me so withdrawn. It hurts my heart so, because accidents, of course, accidents happen. But
those are preventable.
Yes, with firearms, accidents cost lives. Not okay. I had an accident and I, you know, spilled milk all over the place, or you know, I broke the pot or something.
Burned my crotch with hot coffee.
Right.
We literally have an example of a pro athlete making a almost career-ending mistake with a firearm, Plaxico Burress. I mean, you know, and God forbid. Like, what if the same thing, like, what if Ja's playing around with the gun that time and drops it and goes off in the car? Like, you know, on the surface, it's a dumb situation. But when you add the context of everything that has gone on really this season with Ja, it's mainly been this season, it becomes so much worse. The context just, man.
I just think it flies in the face of responsibility. And like, as someone who I do appreciate guns, and but I want you all to own them legally and responsibly. I don't want you to be in a situation where you're like, oh my God, what could have happened? What I should have, could have, would have done. And look, I was a couple weekends ago shooting a 9mm, and me and my cousin were like, as far back from each other as possible. It's like, hey man, we're only shooting that way. Right. And you're only, you know, like with this.
You call hot, you call cold, right, you know, right, there's right. procedures here.
Right. And like, look, I'm not trying to infringe on your rights at all, Ja Morant, for owning a gun, but like, as a public figure, as a 23-year-old, and like, yeah, you can say, oh, you're a basketball player, but dude is a bona fide star with the youth. Dude,
he's
crushing.
Very well liked. He's so influential amongst little kids.
Crushing it in the 10 to 21 demographic, basically, in that range. Well, and so you got to, I'm not saying that you shouldn't influence kids that, like, you got people who are like, oh, those kids shouldn't see guns. You shouldn't put the,
but understand the weight that comes with
right.
your actions that you display to the public.
I think if you want to, you know, show off your guns, you should do so in a more controlled manner, not rapping and dancing in an Instagram video.
Yeah, and just like, yeah, like, it all comes back to the context, because that's more context. Like you said, young kids love Ja Morant. When you add that with the whole incident with the Timberwolves, with the whole incident with the mall, with the whole incident with the kids suing him for, you know, threatening him with guns and beating him up. You know, when you add the context of the last Instagram Live, it just, on the surface, it is a dumb thing to be waving around a gun like he was in the Instagram Live. And it's just a dumb thing. Ooh. But with every layer of context, it's just, I'd be shocked if he's not suspended for at least 25 games.
Dude, it's got to be a full year.
What is, what is Ja's responsibility? Like, okay, why is it that Ja feels like I can get away with anything, which is inherently on, like, we know athletes get special privilege. We know that you can get away with more. Why does he feel like I need to push the limits on what I can get away with? Push the limits on what I can, you know, they didn't punish me for pointing laser guns to the Minnesota Timberwolves. I got away with, you know, punching a 17-year-old kid. I successfully defended my mother against the mall cops. Like, why does he continuously feel like he has to keep pushing the limits of what he can get away with? Like, I know I can get away with a couple things around the station, but, like, you know what you can put. You know, I don't want to keep putting myself in hot water. I don't want to keep pushing the bar. Press it.
Dare I say the worst part of this whole thing is I think everyone, when he was going on that apology tour, was, like, was basically calling him out in the moment. Like, this is not sincere.
No.
Like, people were, like, seeing right through it. This is just PR moves. He does not care, really. And then he goes out and proves everyone exactly right. It's just the worst look in the world.
Dude, do you want to know what I think the answer is, Joe? Do you know why he keeps doing this? Because deep down he knows he's a bitch.
Oh!
Deep down he knows that he is nothing. He's so insecure in himself. And he needs to project externally this faux toughness in order to feel any decency about himself.
But I don't understand how, like, granted, I'm not in his head. I don't understand. There's nothing that shows in his public life that he is soft. Look at him on the court. He will take it to the rack against anyone.
But he never grew up on the streets.
Who cares?
He didn't grow up, you know, running, because that's what he's decided he wants to be in the world. And he knows he's not that.
I don't understand that. Like, the attraction that, like, all of us want to be pro athletes.
I'm not saying it's the smart thing to want to be.
All of us want to be pro athletes, and you want to be, go try to commit, see what you can get away with. Try to go be a gangster. Go try to be a faux criminal. It doesn't make any sense.
It doesn't make any sense to me either.
My man's making an average salary of $38 million.
There is nobody moving any amount of product outside of maybe some of the kingpins that's making that kind of money.
Right, you've made it, my man. Focus on basketball.
Can I also push back on this, something else that's been part of this narrative? People are saying, like, oh, well, Ja clearly doesn't need to be hanging out with these guys because these guys are a bad influence and you're riding around doing stupid Instagram Live videos. Homeboy doing the live had his back. The instant Homeboy saw Ja pull out that pistol and start waving it around, pulled the camera right off of him to the point that you almost had to watch it a few times to see it, and ended the live stream. Homeboy had Ja's back, and Ja is still going out of his way to do dumb things.
Bad judgment for a 23-24-year-old. All right, that's going to do it for us on Cup of Joe. We're going to make room for Big Noon Sports. We've got Matt Coulter, Lars Anderson, and Christian Miller on deck. I'm going to come back with you at 2 o'clock. Ryan Fowler's scouting offensive lineman. So I'm going to be back with you at 2 o'clock today. So I'm going to take a little bit of a break. I'll be right back with you. Big Noon Sports coming up next right here on Tide 100.9. Now.